happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to another video. Today, we are back on Clover Creek. I just had to reload the save game because I had tabbed out of the game and it set the lag in, so we got the 8440 spreading lime on the fields. This is the first field I'm working on right now. The old wheat field. We got the 4440 here. He's waiting and ready to go. Let's get the combine started up. I've been running the combine on auto combine lately, but since I'm recording, I will be running it manually. Otherwise, we have like nothing to do, so. Yeah, so I'm hoping to finish corn pretty soon, hopefully. I think I'm gonna aim to finish corn on Monday's video. Yeah, I think I'll aim to finish corn in Monday's video. So we'll be finishing this field in this video. We only got like two passes left or so, and we'll get started on the next field. And then, right away, once I'm done with this video, I'm going to record tomorrow's video. And then I can have that done and ready. And then, let's see. Then I might work some on this save game. To just try and, you know, I want to get the corn finished soon. I think maybe in, I don't know yet. Let me know, you guys, in Monday's video, do you want to see me finishing that field of corn? Or should I just finish the corn off camera and then in Monday's video, we can just sell all the grain? So you guys let me know. Or actually, up in the top right corner there'll be a little icon. It should have popped up by now already, but yeah, let me know. You know, vote there, pick your option. It'll be up in the top right corner, whether you're on mobile devices or a PC. You can click that at any time, but it will pop up saying, you know, saying something. So yeah, just hit that, put in your vote, and I will take a look at that before I record the next video and go from there. So yeah, I figured I'd start the 84 on putting down some lime, so that way once, hopefully by the time we're done with combining, we'll be done with the fertilizing, and then we can get time fast forwarded once grain is sold and all that stuff, and then can cultivate and get these nutrients up. So that way next season we can have a good yield for our oat, soybean, rye, and sunflower crops. I do need to, I was just thinking of that. Do I have any, trying to think of headers for this combine. I don't want to go with this because this is way too small. But the one that we have is a little on the big side. So I don't know what header I want to use. I don't really want to use this because it like rubs against the tires. It doesn't look that great. This I wanted to try out. For the one that I'm working with Serious Mods on. Just wanted to see how this one was set up. Maybe I can use it as a reference. Maybe we can use this header. I'll have to try that out. Oops. I'll have to try it out, see if I can find a nicer header for this thing, because the case header that we're using now is just, it's a little on the big side. The cart gets way too close to it when it's running, so. Let's see, the 84 is still spreading, correct? Yes, he is just about done, I think. Oh, yeah, he's done. Well, actually, we'll take this guy off of here. Okay, come on. We'll reset that. Okay, so now that's that field done. So now we'll get this one ready to go. Okay, current, this is 31. I'm just overriding all the field edge paths for now. It's just gonna kind of make this a little easier, I think. 31, we'll start in the southwest and head north. Two headlands. So that should put us starting up here somewhere, probably. Actually, you know what? Let's go southeast. Heading north. So that should put it over there. Okay, so that is spread. Now we have to record a refill course. Maybe even we'll be able to upgrade combines even, maybe. We'll see how much money we'll have, you know, by the time this is all said and done. And okay, so I learned from the last course, do not put a waypoint here, otherwise it will not fill itself. Learned that the hard way. But that course can stay, it's fine. Just whenever I spread that field, I will just have to watch it so I can manually get him going again, get him refilled. All I gotta do is just hop over to this guy, hit R, and then I can continue on. Then once it fills up, it drives itself away. So it's about $6,000 to fill this thing. So we're spending a lot of money here, but gotta spend money to make money. So we'll stop, and that is fill. So we set that load spread and fill. F31DN spreader. Try the course at the first waypoint. It's gonna be like up there somewhere or something. Whatever. He can spread to his heart's content, and we can just continue on combining. So hope everybody enjoyed yesterday's video. Where I was working on the Chandler 24 RDT tender trailer model that I had bought from Polygonish a while back. Glad to finally have it in game. Sadly, as you guys saw if you watched the video, there are a couple of weird issues with it. Have not talked to... Well, I did talk to LMB yesterday, and he took a look at it, said, you know, everything checks out on the scripting side. He said, I don't... can't figure out why. And then another friend of mine, he said he was going to take a look at it too, because he had bought the John Deere 9RX from Polygonish, and he said that he had a similar issue with his tracks sinking as I had with my tires sinking on the trailer. So he said he'd take a look at it. So haven't talked to him. I did send him a message, but he's not around at the moment. I just sent him the message so that way I didn't forget about it. And then yeah, so we'll have to see what he says. Let's just get this thing set up for the next field. That should be perfect. Woo. I'm getting off course now. So once we finish this strip, we'll run over to the truck and we'll just unload the combine so that way it's nice and empty for the next field. He is working away over in that alfalfa field that we will be tilling under, since we don't have any animals right now. We don't need it. I have said this before, I'm sure we will do animals eventually on here. It will sadly only be dairy because the beef do not work for me. They only sell for like $1 a ton. If you don't remember, I had did a separate save game here and bought beef. I had 100 head of beef, got them all to where, you know, they were all ready to sell, and then I took 30 of them and sold them, and I got $15. So it's not even $1 a cow, it's like 50 cents a cow. So definitely not worth it. But dairy would be, so we'll do that once we build up. I actually want to look, is there an in-game count? See, the axial flow would be the smallest that I would go in-game. Those are all too big, so are those. Those maybe, these are too big. That's what we have. So maybe we could go with the versatile. I don't know. Might just stick to this combine for a little while and save up for like a John Deere. Or we'll see where we're at. Maybe we get a John Deere 9670 or something. Or even to sell this combine and just, you know, rent the 96 during harvest season until we can afford to buy one or something. But I think after this, once we sell all the grain, and then we should be upwards of maybe 200,000. I guess we do have to pay for that thing. But there is a little bit more wiggle room with the bank. We can take out a little more loan. I'm not sure exactly how much more loan I can take out, but I can take out some more. But yeah, I think probably renting the combine will probably be the best bet. And then just sell this combine and both the headers. And then we can just rent the combine whenever we need to harvest. But I would much prefer to own it, because otherwise every single time we harvest, we have to drive it all the way from the dealership to the farm with one header. And then once we're done with that crop, you know, done harvesting the crops with that header, then we have to drive all the way back up to the dealership, take back the one header, get the other, bring it all the way back. Be a lot more driving than, I guess, unless we used a header trailer or something, but we'll have to see, I guess. We'll see what kind of money we get from the harvest here. So I just want to make sure that this guy is actually going to stop and do everything that I want him to. Otherwise, we have to re-record all these courses, which I would rather not do. Yeah. Dang. That is not going to work. Crap. I guess I'll just have to really watch now for when he empties. Oh, come on. Well, that's kind of a bummer. I was really hoping that would work correctly. Guess I do need that waypoint. I don't really want to reset the course now either because it's already been spreading. Ah, heck with it. We'll do it, I guess. Okay, so let's go field 31. Southeast heading north with 2. This is spread. Reset that. That definitely sucks. I was really hoping that I would not have to redo this. But I guess I know now for future reference to always put a waypoint here. Put a waypoint. Okay, so this guy has just a little bit in it. So we will leave that sit there. Getting this field opened up once the spreader is ready to rock and roll. Okay, so that guy's good to go. What the world? I don't know why it just set that. So then that is fill. Let's see if it'll go to current waypoint. Not sure what it'll do when I hit that, but we'll find out. Drive the course. Okay, it is gonna memorize it. Alright, cool. F31DN spreader. Good deal. I want that activated. I don't know why that deactivated itself, but. Alright, and away we go. So this field is still pretty poor, too. I don't know, they were all pretty good for a while there, but I don't know what happened. I was just going to check how much time we had left, but I don't dare do that because my luck, the game would drop to like 10 to 15 frames again like it did when the first time I tried recording this video. I tried like 5 times. This is like the 4th or 5th attempt at making this video. Another thing we could do to make a little cash is rent a mower and a baler. Mower, you know, like some stuff to make some bales, and could bale all these grass strips here and sell some hay. That could work too. I don't know what kind of yield they'd get off of that, because the grass doesn't have very good nutrients either, but definitely be worth a shot, I bet. But I think we'll save our money and use it for other things that we need. Okay, so let's flip this 90 degrees and let's just open up this end here. So that way, when I go back to using the auto combine, he can do the end rows here. He can come all the way down to the end and not want to go in circles around the field, even though I have him set in up and down mode. I have had that happen many times, because auto combine is not the greatest in terms of smarts. Neither is course play, but they both get the job done. They do cause me some damage, but what can you do? It's definitely a whole lot quieter inside here. So now when we go back to up and down, all I gotta do is rotate the course 90 degrees again, and it'll be exact. Since I didn't adjust anything when I turned it this way, it won't have changed anything for going up and down either. So we'll be able to go right back to the way we were going. This field I manually spread. I made a course play course, but I drove myself by following the course. So that's why there are lines in it from wheels. Except, I don't know, some of it has the tracks and some of it doesn't. Unless, like, course play was close to being done or something and I just took over, or I don't know what the deal was there. Oh, that guy is ready to be refilled. So, here's what he does. He just pulls up to the waypoint. I hit R. I continue on with what I'm doing. Man, I keep wanting to hit 2 instead of 3 for the cruise control. We'll get a face full of dust. Should be nearing the end of the video, I think. I'm not 100% positive on that. What I should start doing is I should just start using it on my phone for when I'm doing Clover Creek here, because then I don't have to I don't have to worry about tabbing out in the game, lagging. That's what I might start doing. There. Nothing. Okay. Pretty big section to cut out here. Pretty decent sized. I'm glad that this header works with this combine. I know somebody in one of the groups I'm in, they were talking about doing the header for this thing, asking if somebody would in-game it if they worked on it. I don't know whatever happened to that. Not sure if they decided to go through with it, or decided not to, or what. Okay. Oh, I was worried there for a second. Okay, that just closed. Alright. Okay, so I think I'm just gonna kinda end the video like 2 minutes early or something. So as I said earlier, make sure that, you know, if you didn't already, up in the right hand corner, click the little icon, and it's like a little eye inside of a circle, and click on that and put in your vote on finish corn harvest in the next video, or finish harvest and start selling grain, or just start selling grain. So make sure that you do that. You can put it in the comments too, whatever. I'll be checking both. So anyways guys, that's going to do it for this video. I don't want to bore you too much, even though I probably have. There's not a whole lot going on this map. A lot of harvest because it feels pretty big, but yeah guys, that's